Hello again, students. Our topic today is parts of the four basic operations and solving it following the MDAS rules. I know that most of you are already good in multiplying, dividing, and adding, and subtracting, but most of you still don't know the parts of the four operations and also the MDAS rules. So listen and watch carefully on the video so that you will gain knowledge on it. First, on the four basic operations is we have addition. The parts of addition are addend and sum. You can see it here that it has upper addend and lower addend. The upper addend is 6 and the lower addend is 3. And we call the answer sum. That is number 9. So those are the parts of addition. We have another example here. We have there the first addend or upper addend, that is 4, and the symbol, that is plus, and we have also the second addend or lower addend, that is 1, and the symbol equals, and the last, that is the answer, we call it sum, that is 5. We have again another example. We have number 2, that is upper addend, and number 3, the lower addend, and 5, that is the answer. We call it sum or total. So again, the parts of addition are upper addend, the lower addend, and the sum. So those are the parts of addition. Now we go to the next operation. By the way, before we go to the next operation, we will discuss first the meaning of the parts of addition, which are addend and sum. So addend means a number which is added to another or any numbers that are added together. And sum means total. So that's the meaning of the parts of addition. So that's it for addition. Now we go to the next topic. The second operation is subtraction. So we have the parts. These are minuend, subtrahend, and difference. We have there number 9, that is minuend, and the 3, that is subtrahend. And the answer, which is number 6, we call it difference. So these are the parts of subtraction. We have again another example. Here we have 5 as the minuend and 1 as the subtrahend, and the answer 4 as the difference. One more example, wherein the symbol minus and equals are written. It shows there that 7 is minuend, 3 is subtrahend, and 4 is difference. So that is the parts of subtraction. We will go now to the meaning of the parts of subtraction. First is subtrahend. It means a number to be subtracted from another, or the second number in a subtraction. Next is minuend. It means a number from which another is to be subtracted, or the first number in subtraction. And of course, the answer of subtraction, we call it difference. So that's all for the parts of subtraction. We will proceed again to the next, which is multiplication. The third operation is multiplication. And here are the parts of multiplication. The upper part is multiplicand, that is 6. In the middle part, that is multiplier, that is number 3. In the lower part, that is the answer, which is number 18. We call it product. Another example, we have 15 as the multiplicand and 2 as the multiplier, and the answer 30 as the product. Again, one more example. You can see it here that we have 13 as the multiplicand, 6 as the multiplier, and 78 as the product. So these are the parts of the multiplication. Always remember that the upper part is multiplicand, and the middle is multiplier, and the answer is product. We go now to the meaning of the parts of multiplication. We have multiplicand, it means the number being multiplied, and the multiplier, it means the number doing the multiplying. And the answer, that is product or multiple. So we have two names of the answer of multiplication. You can call it product or multiple. So that's all for the multiplication. We will proceed to the last operation, that is division. Last operation, we have division. The parts of division, we have dividend, that is 18, and divisor, that is number 3, and the answer, that is 6. We call it quotient. We have another example here, wherein it has a remainder. So we have here 11 as the dividend, 2 as the divisor, and 5 as the quotient, and 1 as the remainder. Alright, let's go now to the meaning of the parts of division. So first is dividend. It means the number being divided, while divisor is a number that will divide the dividend. And quotient is the result of division. What about remainder? Remainder is the number that's left after you divide. So that's all about the parts of division. We will proceed now to our last lesson, that is M.'s rule. Actually a rule to follow when we are going to solve a series of operations. There is the four fundamental operations of real numbers. M.'s rule stands for multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. So how are we going to use this rule? First, we have to perform all multiplications and divisions before performing the additions and subtraction. In performing all multiplications and division, we should solve or read it from left to right. Do not try to solve any multiplication or division, since it is easier or convenient to you to solve. Always solve from left to right, whatever that comes first. Follow the same process for additions and subtraction. Though we can apply the rule of signed numbers, or we can also use the commutative law of addition. In M.'s rules, remember this rule: multiplication and division first, then addition and subtraction. So if you're going to solve a multiplication and division, you should go left to right. Same with addition and subtraction. The actual example. So we have there 10 times 5 divided by 25 plus 8 minus 2 times 2 plus 4 minus 3 is equals blank. In solving this, we perform first 10 times 5 together with 2 times 2, giving us 50 divided by 25 plus 8 minus 4 plus 4 minus 3 is equals blank. Then we have to solve 50 divided by 25 before performing the addition and subtraction. So we have 2 plus 8 minus 4 plus 4 minus 3, which is equal to 10 minus 4 plus 4 minus 3, and the final answer is 7. This is the answer in simplified equation. So that's all for this MDAS rules and for our lesson today. So we are going to continue it again next time. So see you again in my next video.